Well, g'day, g'day. It's Tim Pachalka, the Aussie Android Dev Guy, here with another video. Today, we're talking about setting up the path for Android development on a Linux machine. Now, this involves setting the path for Java, but also for the Android development tools. So we're going to do that for Linux. Now, if you're wanting to do this on a Mac or on a Windows machine, refer to the videos to my left, and I've got a video to show you how to do that on your machine, because or on your platform, I should say, and that's because it's different on a platform-by-platform basis. So let's get into now setting up the various Android development command line paths for Linux.
First things, we're going to open the applications and go into terminal. Let's move this over a little bit. I'm going to type Java space minus version. Now, if that comes back with a version, like you can see on the screen there, Java version 1.8.0_25, that means we have installed Java. If you get some sort of weird error, or it's a version under that, like it's 1.7 or something like that, refer to my video, which you can click on the icon on screen now to go to that video and make sure you install the most recent version of Java. And while you're there, make sure you also install Android Studio. There's a link on the screen now to install that as well. So we're going to assume that you've done that and you've now got Java version 1.8 or higher and also got Android Studio installed on this computer. So moving forward, we'll type sudo space su, type in our regular password, then going to type which space Java, and that gives us a symbolic link to where Java is installed. And think of a symbolic link as a shortcut in Windows terms. It's just basically a shortcut to where Java is installed on the computer. What we need to know is the actual folder. So we're going to type read link space minus f slash usr slash bin slash java. And that'll give us the location on the computer where that's installed. So what we need is the path now so that we can set our Java underscore home variable. So the part we want is this main part here. That's the part that we want to take a copy of. And I'm just holding down my left mouse button and copying that. Click on copy. So we don't want the part after the slash JRE slash bin slash Java. We don't want that part. We only want to put the path in. So next I'm going to open a new window. I'm going to go to file and click on open tab. Got another tab open and I'm going to type gedit. Well, firstly I'm going to do a pwd and see that we're in our home folder, so I'm going to type gedit.bashrc. That brings up this little bash script. I'm going to scroll to the bottom of that and I'm going to type java underscore home equals, and I'm going to paste in the value that I copied a minute ago down here. I'm going to paste that in. So that's our path to Java. We don't need the last slash, so I'm just going to remove that. So that's number one thing. Then we're going to type export java underscore home. That is going to tell the script when it executes that to set up the Java home to that pointer. So that's basically all we need to do. So that's now setting up the Java underscore home variable that we need to access. So once we've done that, the next step now is to go back to our terminal. I'm just going to move that over a little bit so I've got a bit more space. I'm going to click on the first tab again. Next, I'm going to just type in the word export in lowercase, press enter. And that gives us a whole heap of gobbledygook. But the part we're looking for here is this path. We need to make sure that path is correctly defined and it should have Java in it. Now, normally you would have, or you may or may not have, Java already in there. So if you see a folder there with Oracle and so forth, it means that it's already been configured. But if it's something else you can see here, clearly Oracle and Java is not in the path, so we're going to have to add that. So what we're going to do is go back to our other script, path equals, I'm going to type dollar java underscore home, which I'll make a space here just to clear it, it's a little bit easy to read. So it's java path slash bin, then we're going to type dollar java underscore home slash db slash bin colon dollar java underscore home slash jre slash bin. That's putting the required folders into the class path for us, which is good. We'll need to come back to that. So the next thing we now need to do is we need to go and find and set up the Android SDK environment variable, and then we need to put the various folders into the path. So to do that, we need to start up Android Studio. So I'm going to go and do that. Open up Android Studio. Then we need to go into Configure, Project Defaults, and then Project Structure. And that gives us the Android SDK location. So I'm going to copy that. Taking a copy of that. And I'm going to go back into here. And I'm going to type just above the path, Android underscore home equals. And I'm going to paste in that value. And next, we need to go back to that path and put another colon and type $android_home/tools:, and then $android_home/platform/tools. Finally, we need to end that with another colon and the $path. Now, it's important to get the case on these. Case sensitivity is important here, so make sure you've typed it as you can see on the screen. Now, what that line does, it sets up and adds Java to the path to make sure that can be accessed, but it also sets up the Android SDK so we can access the Android SDK various tools from the command line as well. And then the $path on the end adds to the end of the path that we've created whatever was previously on there so that doesn't get chopped off. And one thing I forgot to do, after the Android home, we need to type export Android_home. That saves that and exports it. Then lastly, we need to type export path. So at this point, we've now added Java and the Android SDK to the path, and we've also defined two environment variables pointing to the relevant paths. So what we'll do now is we're going to save that. I'm going to click on save. I'm going to close it down. Cancel. We're going to close down Android Studio. We need to close down the folder. We need to close down Terminal. See, what I'll do is I'll just type exit to close it down. And exit again, because there was two of them and I had to get out of the SU that I was in. And that's closed it down. I'm just going to open it again now. And by opening it again, it's going to execute that bash script. So now if we type export and scroll up, you can see we've now got all these folders that are now in the path that weren't there before at the top there. You can see the ones I'm talking about are, these are the ones that we've added. We added all of those. Now, if you do see this, you can see here, there's obviously a duplication. So I didn't see that when I was typing before. Perhaps I missed it. It means that the Java path was already defined and I've just duplicated it at the front. So I could go back to my bash RC script and just remove the first references that I added to add Java to the path if necessary. It won't hurt to leave that there for now. But the main thing is the Android tools are there. And also, just scrolling up, now Java_home is now defined, which it should be, pointing to the right place. And also scrolling up, we've also got Android_home pointing to the right place. So obviously we need to type Java --version, which should still work anyway, but we'll type that. So that's good, that's still working. But the other thing we can type is Android. And if we get that coming up, the SDK manager comes up, we know that we've got the paths all correct. If you get an error there, it means there was some sort of problem with not being able to access Java, or more likely that you've typed in the Android SDK folders incorrectly.
And that's a wrap. We're done and dusted. I hope you enjoyed that video. Please do click on the subscribe button to the left of me if you want to be kept up to date with future videos as I release them, which of course are all about Android. And if you're interested in Android development, please also click on the link below me and check out my Android video course with 25 plus hours of video footage, 11,000 students, something that is of interest to beginners or advanced developers alike. Also, check out some of my videos. Click on here, some of the videos to the left-hand side, if you're interested in some of the things that you see on there, and you can see more, yet more videos from me. And last, but by no means least, if you've got time, please do leave a comment and let me know what you thought of the video, what you got out of it, and of course, what you'd like me to cover in future videos. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in another video. Adios. This is Tim Pachauka, the Aussie Android Dev Guy, signing off. Cheers for now.